Welcome back to the SISU studio here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup in Calgary, Canada. My name's Panda.
I'm Bob Natchez.
And we are going to be going into our very last game of the day. Can you believe it?
I cannot.
What an incredible day. It's going to be game 24. Unbelievable. 24 single period games that we've had here today. And this is going to be on track two. So it'll be Sweden versus Chile. On track one at the minute, we have USA taking on Japan. Japan still yet to score any points. There was touch and go for a moment there. We thought there was going to be some points on the board. The crowd certainly wanted them and weren't happy when they weren't given. 99 points on the board for Team USA. Probably going to be breaking into triple figures anytime soon. So going into the Sweden-Chile game, any thoughts on that before the game, Bob?
Honestly, that could be fairly close. Mm-hmm. And it plays into that group. It affects how that group comes together. So it'll be interesting to see what happens. And of course, what we really want to remind you is to stick around after each of these two games, because we will have all of today's results put together so that we can tell you how the pools are shaping up and if anybody's locked it up already.
Absolutely. We're going to check in hopefully with Statman around that time as well to try and bring you a little bit more concise information. He's on top of things. That's why we've got him as part of the group. He's got everything. We're trying to bring you all the stats and the updates as much as we can as we get the information through. But if you want to get that checked out in the meantime, please head over to mrdwc.com for all the live updates and information. If you want to jump onto Twitter, it's on there as well, at mrdwclive.
Otherwise, all we would remind you is tomorrow we continue with pool play. We will finish that up. We will end the day with a JRDA showdown as well as one full-length placement game.
Absolutely. So that's going to be a really good end to the day before we move into Saturday and Sunday and see the full-length games, full regulation games. Really looking forward to it.
Absolutely.
Okay, so I think we're about ready to go across to track two. I've been Panda.
I'm Bob.
We'll see you soon.
Here we are. Back at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup, I am Raucous Ron, and with me tonight, Holly. How you doing out there, Derbyverse? What's up, Holly?
Oh, I've been having a whale of a time this first day. We've seen some brilliant matchups here on the SISU track. I've even had some time to go over and check out the Quad Skate Stores track as well. Games have been fantastic,
and yes,
we are up for a brilliant game here.
Yeah, I like this matchup. This is Chile versus Sweden, and these two teams seem fairly evenly matched, so we're in for a good game. They are taken to the floor here, and I can tell they're getting ready for the signal, so we may have to go through the lineups in just a minute.
I can tell you're jamming, though, for Sweden. We've got No Modesty Blaze, and Sweden playing in that bright yellow.
And for Chile, we've got Insane.
No Modesty Blaze going for that outside line. Insane testing inside and out. No Modesty Blaze just now pushing through. Sees that inside line opened up for the wrong jammer.
Oh. And you can give that one to the blockers, opening up that inside lane with that wall block. You would love the seal block.
Really good work there. Good offense. And No Modesty Blaze coming back around again. Chile down to just three blockers. Beautiful jump up that inside line.
Yeah, Insane powers through, trying to keep the scoring low here. Something I'm noticing right off the bat is a size difference between these teams, at least that are on the floor and the way it looks from the bench. Some difference between the Chileans and the Swedish.
Yeah, and that is going to be represented in the two jammers we've got lined up now, as you can see on your screens.
Yeah.
We have got number four, that's Yada Yada for Sweden. And he's up against number 77, Mankalipe for Chile.
And Kalipe doing some great work in earlier games today, I was witness to. Yada Yada, gets knocked to the inside, almost cuts track, and then recycled back. Holly.
Yep, some brilliant work there, and that is Kiltro taking him back. He's now trying that outside line, Yada Yada, taking good hits there to the chest, but he's keeping himself upright, and indeed on his toes, pushes through that inside line and breaks lead jammer to Sweden.
Well, almost got him out of bounds, but almost is not good enough.
Almost never works in Derby. Really good evasive work there by number 77, that's Mankalipe. But Yada Yada calls the jam off, he's been knocked to the outside line, Let's see if the JAMA referee gives them any points on that pass. It's a zero at the moment for Chile and three for Sweden.
So we'll start off here with 8 points for Sweden and zero for Chile.
We've got Fritzen on the JAMA line for Sweden.
And Insane once again for Chile.
Steady approach by both jammers, just eyeing each other up, it seemed, as they approached the wall. Fritzen going for that outside. He's here at the back with the Chilean four wall. Ooh. And that looks like a bit of space opened up. It's closed up again, though, for Insane.
Yeah, nice defensive work, but you can't fall down out of bounds. Well, Fritzen with the pass.
You can, but it doesn't help.
It's not going to be as effective. Insane through on the initial pass as well, but Fritzen up the outside, gets knocked to the inside. Looking back and being told to call it off by the bench coaches. So adding another four to the score for Sweden.
I think he might have been having a bit of a decision as to whether to go back on track, seeing that the blocker had gone down. But he had moved quite a distance away, so he may even have come up with a skating out of bounds penalty had he done so. So I think a very clever move for that call off.
Yes, I'm noticing from the first game of today when Chile played, they're doing much better job team blocking. And that's because the team had never worked together before. They've never played a game. They're from different leagues and they're a collection of skaters. But they're starting to look more and more like a team here. Holly.
It's a great way to bring them together. And we've got now Lee Jama going to Sjöberg Olsson for Sweden. He just powered his way through that inside line. And it's number 8, Cyborg, for Chile, who's just pushed his way through, so he's about half a lap behind Sjöberg. Oh, hit to the inside, and he's calling it off on his knees.
Sjöberg also putting in good work today. All of these skaters, you know, one of the things I love about World Cup is the camaraderie between the skaters. You know, there's, you know, not a lot of history between them, and everybody's happy to meet different people from different cultures. And I'm really appreciating that and seeing that after each game in the attention they're giving each other and taking the time to hug or shake hands and really meeting each other, which is
fantastic atmosphere here.
It is. It really is. Amen Calipe for Chile.
He's up against No Modesty Blaze. No Modesty being held at the back. Knocked off. Really good recycle there. That's Kiltro. Oh, we tried to get a recycle in as well on Mankalipe, who's taken on that outside line. Rushes for that inside, dodges through one, but he's being held back again. I think the Sweden having that size difference is really helping them in their defense against the smaller Chilean jammers.
Oh, certainly. And Chile is definitely going to have to help their jammers, these smaller jammers, with some offensive blocking.
Well, Mankalipe has now taken off the star and he's managed to evade his way through that pack. No Modesty Blaze, however, has scored. He is calling that jam to an end. We've got a slight injury, it looks like, on one of the Chilean players, being assisted by Sweden, as you were saying, that camaraderie and just that helping between the teams, regardless of where they're from, is fantastic.
And quite interesting, this setup that we have today, where we're going 30 minutes and we're not stopping for timeouts or penalties, each team getting one team timeout and not necessarily using it because it runs more clock down.
It does.
So and 5 penalties, which I think is an advantage because we're not seeing the foul outs. And, you know, when they're new skaters working together, you're going to see more penalties.
Yada yada, racing around that outside line for Lee Jama. And he's up against Mechanico, who's jamming for the first time, who has picked up a blocking with the head penalty. So this is now a Roller Derby Athletics power jam for Yada Yada and Team Sweden.
Yada Yada, certainly the tallest skater on his team.
Oh, he has a very clever work there by Insane. He actually jumped back, and that penalty was picked up by the OPR. Really, really cleverly timed.
Nice. So potentially an opportunity here for Chile to score, still needing the initial pass. Am I correct?
They are indeed.
Yes. At least the window is open.
It is. Mechanico now through on that inside line, not lead jammer. And Yada Yada, however, also breaking free. Oh, big hit, taking him down on turn number one by Insane, but Insane recycling himself back, and Yada Yada can get back up having put 5 points on the board.
Mechanico knocked out of bounds there during the scoring opportunity. Not really having much luck getting past the hips of these skaters.
He is
really
definitely
pushing.
Trying.
Yes. Digging in. Mechanico now skating out of bounds.
That's a blocking out of bounds.
Blocking out of bounds.
I think he must have been pushing with his leg, straddling over the track, and that will give him that penalty. So we've got another roller derby athletics power jam going to Sweden. And it's still yada yada, trying to put those points back on the scoreboard. Currently at 24, they're taking it nice and steady, and we've had the most gentlemanly star pass I've ever seen. So jamming now is Cyborg.
There you go. Oh, you want me to take that? Okay.
Oh, okay. Thank you. Shall we have tea later? Oh, and we have got points on the board for Chile.
Yes, and valiantly fought for by the Chilean team. Let's try and run you through the roster, one of the rosters at least, real quick. We've got for Chile, we've got Kiltro, Mimiro, Virtua Thunder, Vieja, Mr. Socrum, Capitan Basaritas, Insane, Aquiles, Kamikaze, Moncalipe, Cyborg, Mechanico, Toro, and Marmota.
And Mechanico just standing up in the penalty box. And that leaves Fritzen a chance to get lead. He takes that chance and comes now around on a scoring pass as Mechanico hits that Swedish wall at the back. He's dropped down to the ground, but back up very quickly. Testing that outside line, just not quite able to stay on the track. To the outside, but that is a cutting penalty, and Fritzen can't quite believe it. He's incredulous about the penalty.
And another roller derby athletics power jam here for Chile, and they could certainly use it right about now at 28-2 in favor of Sweden.
Mechanico taking really big hits. That was number 4-2 Papa for Sweden, knocking him down to the ground.
Is there a penalty for laying on the jammer?
there is a penalty for laying on the jammer. And we've had a star pass now through to Insane, who's just going to take some time to put it on because he wants to
gather some momentum and get some blockers
indeed.
Headed that way.
Fritzen now out of the box, breaking free. Valiant attempt at the front to slow him down. By the Chilean blocker.
Blocker's hitting hard in there for Chile, but to no avail as Fritzen is out for another pass.
Yeah, he's almost shrugging those hits off as they come in. Insane being recycled out on the outside line as Fritzen comes back in, tests the outside, tries to push through the middle, but the jam comes to an end. Points apiece there.
Mm-hmm. So Sweden at 38, Chile at 4. I'm enjoying seeing the way Chile is really coming together with their blockers. And, you know, it may not seem that way with the score, but I can tell they're playing with tighter packs. They're doing more bracing. I think they're starting to figure each other out. And later on in the weekend, they should hit some teams that will be a little bit less of a challenge for them.
And,
you know, certainly still plenty of time in this one, you know.
And they still seem to be enjoying every moment as
That's
well.
Right.
Manjelipe, the Chilean jammer, a very tall yellow wall that he's coming up against. He is trying to get himself low and under their arms and shoulders. He's getting some momentum up at the front, but knocked to the outside. And that will be number 8 who's taken him out, which is Nielsen. In the meantime, it's Sjöberg Olsen jamming at the front for Sweden. He is pushing his way through, trying, testing those edges, but he's also being recycled back.
There's that coordinated blocking, and we're starting to see more of for Chile.
Chile taken down to 3 blockers. Will this play in Sweden's advantage? We've had nearly a minute go. We've got 50 seconds gone with no lead called. This is brilliant defensive work from both teams.
And Sjöberg Olsen, named lead, now getting some offensive help. Manjelipe
Uribe being dragged back. And again, that forewall of Sweden. It must be so imposing to see just those shoulders right in front of your face. Mm-hmm. Offensive work by Crutzen there to try and break apart the Chilean wall. But Sjoberg Olsen is taken back a long, long way.
Oh, look at that big hit on the front end from Nkalipe. Said, I'm coming through. I don't care how big you are.
Mehmet Iro trying to take Sjoberg Olsen off. Again, he's almost shrugging those hits off. You can see them coming in. They're not phasing him at all.
Yes, and Chile's getting tougher and tougher, but Sweden playing like a team that has played together. And we're certainly seeing the effect of them being, you know, in Europe where they easy travel to play against other teams and having had some experience working together.
Yeah, there has been quite a lot of inter-team play in Europe the past couple of years.
There has.
We're seeing No Modesty Blaze coming up against Kiltro.
Nice seal block, locking in those blockers to the outside. We're seeing that repeatedly from them. It's almost as if there's a strategic ploy.
Kiltro breaking free, about half a lap behind No Modesty Blaze. No Modesty Blaze getting that knock to the outside. Pulls that jab to an end.
Fantastic. Bruce Skate News, the original over-the-shoulder roller skate holder. You spend a lot of money on those skates. Don't shove them in a bag full of sweaty gear. Your skates hate that. Keep your skates aired out and show them off with Bruised Skate News. Find us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, or online at bruisedsn.com. bruisedsn.com.
We've got Insane for Chile up against Yada Yada. Yada Yada, with those long legs, just stepping over the legs of his opponents in that very tight mishmash pack. But he is knocked to the outside. Lovely jump back there by Bruto Thunders. And it is lead jammer to Chile. That's Insane picking up that lead. Lots of whistles happening in the far corner. In the meantime, Insane sneaks his way through. And the audience really appreciative of the points that Chile are now putting on the board. Yada Yada now breaking free at the front. Insane not happy with how he's being blocked. It is, however, legal blocking that was coming in from Crutzen. And Insane calls that jam to an end. Three extra points. That's Chile picking up 8 points in that jam, and that brings them up to 12 playing against Sweden's 43 with just over 15 minutes left in this game.
Wonderful. Dick DeFont says, cheering on Team Chile. Seems to be a bit of a height difference between the Chileans and the Swedes, as we've pointed out here. We do have over on the other track, we've got Team Japan versus Team USA, which makes John Kershaw very happy.
Jamming right now for Sweden, we have Akiez. And he is up against number 2-3 for Chile. Just Mimiro. Mimiro now lead jammer. That's Chile picking up two leads in a row. And chasing him down is Fritzen for Sweden. Fritzen jamming. Mimiro dodging around that inside line. Breaking free. And he calls that jam to an end. 4 points. Sweden sneaking 3 points in. Fritzen doing really well to pick up the pace and grab those final 3 points. But Chile now up to 16 against Sweden's 46.
Well, we definitely like to hear from you out there. We know there's people in Chile watching the game. As they're on similar time zone. So, you know, from Chile, tweet in with a shout out to your players. We'll try and get that to you. We have a team timeout over to Sweden. And with that, we're going to take you to one of our sponsors. Right back to the track here. We've got Chile in the blue with red accents. And we have Sweden with the yellow and blue accents, if you didn't know already.
Yeah, this is Sweden's second kit. They have been playing in blue so far today. So a lot of their fans will have come through assuming the blue would be Sweden, but this is their secondary kit in that bright sunshine yellow. Kiltro for Chile on the line, and he's up against Sjoberg Olsen as the 5 second call comes through.
One blocker in the box for Sweden. Kiltro very strong, pushing and picks up lead jam for Chile.
That's three times in a row Chile have managed to pick up lead jammer.
Wow. They're picking up some momentum here. They're losing one to the box.
Sjoberg Olsen has broken free, but that jam comes to an end. Sweden held to a zero, and Chile picking up four more points. This is starting to bring the game a little bit closer. Yeah. Chile on 20, Sweden on 46.
Certainly, and maybe more importantly, some momentum.
Definitely.
Switching in favor of Chile, and we've seen them progress throughout the day, as I'd mentioned. In terms of their working together as a team and their skill. And maybe that's coming together a little bit here with Sweden.
We're seeing the progression throughout this game as well. If they can keep that momentum on the up, they've got a chance to pull it back with over 11 minutes remaining. Mechanico now on the line for Chile. And he is facing off against No Modesty Blaze, who just comes powering in after that recycle. I think he took it quite personally there.
So strong.
Just pushes his way around his own wall. Oh, but he is being assessed a cutting penalty. Had to ask a couple of times if it was his, as there were two penalties at the same time.
Oh, and now a cut track for Chile as well. So we will have a switch out to jammer position and opportunity lost there for Chile.
Sweden still setting themselves up at the back. Ready to power through, I believe, as No Modesty Blaze enters the track.
No Modesty Blaze so strong, and we've seen that throughout the day. And with big hits like that, how brave of Cyborg to take on the big Swede.
That was a beautiful sweep, however, from Sweden, just clearing that inside line, just one after each other. No Modesty Blaze knocked to that outside line now, and Chile's jammer, Mechanico, just getting a push from his teammates into that wall to try and push them further and further away. But that Swedish wall is barely moving. It's been stuck here now on turn number three for quite some time, as No Modesty Blaze tests that outside line, stays on his foot and gets low, powers around the outside. That's another set of points for Sweden. Blocking with the head, assessed again to Chile's jammer. Mechanico this time picking it up. And this gives a Roller Derby Athletics power jam to No Modesty Blaze of Sweden. Well, it did for a brief moment, and they can start on a Roller Derby Athletics power jam.
Lucas Loyola on Twitter says, Vamos CTM, vamos Chile.
It's great hearing from all of the fans across the world. Please
it
do
really
tweet
is.
In if you are listening, watching. I know a lot of people just have it on in the kitchen while listening to it. Some people are watching. I obviously recommend watching it to get the full experience. But let us know, hashtag MRDWC. Let us know how it's going on, how this World Cup's doing for you.
And we appreciate the advice coming in on pronunciation. So,
yes.
You know, we're... Where I'm from, it's Chile, is how we pronounce Chile. Chile, as I guess how now someone's telling me to pronounce it.
Yes, Chile.
Chile.
And we have got this Roller Derby Athletics power jam in favor of Sweden, and it is Yada Yada who has taken this start, power start. Breaks through pretty quickly. Sweden dropping back with the 2-for-2 formation. They're holding back and letting Yada Yada just go on his own, and he's knocked out. So a slight delay. And again, knocked to that inside line. Chile doing a really good job with just the two blockers on the track against this very tall, very agile Jammer.
Yeah, excellent work with two recycles in a row by Kamikaze.
Oh, beautiful. That was fantastic.
A little bit of a dusting off the shoulder there afterwards and big smiles. And again, we've got such positive attitudes. And, you know, we've seen some, oh, yeah, nice replay there of diving under, first a taking on the blocker and then diving under the second blocker.
That was beautiful work by Memeiro. Just give a quick shout out to the Men's Roller Derby World Cups. They'd like to acknowledge the contribution of Alberta Sports Connection, which helped make this event possible.
On our jam. Friedson on the jam line, the Nerdscape shop jammer line, that is. Taking on Insane. Insane having a lot of success today from the jammer position. They've got a deep rotation of jammers and they're resting, but then again, everyone's blocking as well. Friedson powering through on the front end, getting space and taking advantage.
Yeah, plenty of out of plays being issued. So Chile down again to just the two blockers. However, we have had a break by Insane. As Fritzen's powering his way through, getting those shoulders in. Cyborg just doesn't know how to deal with it. And a quick call off as directed by his bench. It's bringing our scores currently. Chile on 20, Sweden on 62. And we've got just over 6 minutes left in this game. Looking at the track, we have Kamikaze against Sjoberg Olsen. Sjoberg with an easy dart around the front foremost blocker for Chile, just managed to get them at the right angle to break free. Oh, we've got a ref interaction there. A little bit of a nudge by Kamikaze. But he's picking up a misconduct, sorry. I believe that may be for that ref hit. You cannot contact with a referee, I'm afraid. So a misconduct penalty. This is giving a Roller Derby Athletics power jam to Sjoberg, now pushing his way around at the front. And Chile, again, they are picking up quite a few out-of-play penalties. I'm not sure if they're not hearing it or if, again, it's the development that they're bringing into this game, but those out-of-play penalties really annihilating their blockers on the track.
Yeah, lots of skill on the track, but maybe a little inexperience, as mentioned.
Sjoberg just taking his time round against our pivot for Chile. All it took was a little yada yada to knock him out of the way. And that's another grand slam for the Swedish team. Chile now split apart. In come the Swedish offense one more time. Memeiro was doing a fantastic job one-on-one, and he's back up there again, chest to chest. Still blocking Sjoberg, but Sjoberg Olsen just spins his way around the inside.
Yes, now able to take advantage of the Roller Derby Athletics power jam with Sjoberg Olsen. Five more, now starting to get some serious separation on the scoreboard with only just under 4 minutes remaining. It's 82 for Sweden, 20 for Chile.
Yeah, beautiful work there by Memeiro, I thought. Just working almost as a solo blocker for the majority of that jam.
Really enjoying seeing these new skaters that we've never seen before. A lot of superstars or future superstars out there that have got super talented, and we'll be hearing their names again and again in the future.
Oh, absolutely. We saw it in the previous Men's World Cup with the likes of Argentina and Japan,
yes,
who have just been storming today as well. Argentina doing a sterling job and really getting some good points up on. And they were complete unknowns in the first Men's Roller Derby World Cup.
Came out of nowhere with a very small squad. Now they have a larger squad, and they're doing great work. And we really appreciate them for traveling all this way as Chile.
Whilst we're taking an official time out, we'll just give you a quick shout out to the Quad Skate Shop team of the tournament. If you are listening to us, also make sure you're checking out during Saturday's play our Facebook page, as we are now letting you choose one of our MVPs. This year's Quad Skate Shop team of the tournament will include a fan favourite award chosen by you. So check out the Facebook page for the Men's Roller Derby World Cup, where we'll give you more details on how you can put forward your nomination for the fan favourite to join that Quad Skate Shop team of the tournament.
Fantastic. And we have another tweet in. This one's from Captain Maus. Big love from me to Sweden and the salty seamen on track, and my fellow UK mouths, Snogs, Sven, Smack, Crazy, Holly, and Mr. James Brown over there. So some love over here to our producer, James Brown and Holly.
Yeah, Captain Maus coming from Manchester Roller Derby, which is my home league. So it's great to hear that he's still listening in, as it is probably about 4 o'clock in the morning, just coming up to 4 o'clock in the morning UK time. And we've got a Roller Derby Athletics Power Jam start for No Modesty Blaze of Sweden. Just the two Chilean blockers, and No Modesty Blaze just powering through.
Yeah, you've got to love like a freight train just moving right into the chest of the opposing player. No attempt to go around them, through them.
So you are moving out of my way. This is my track. However, Chile now back up to three blockers, and it is starting to slow No Modesty Blaze down. And that's given a little bit of space for Insane to break through. However, No Modesty Blaze very much aware of what's happening.
Yes, and we are down to 1 minute on the clock here. We really appreciate the participation of all of the fans out there. And I know the teams on the track would like to thank everyone at home, the referees, the skaters from fellow leagues that have helped them to get here. You know, their families that have put up with the time they spend in roller derby and the travel, and everyone who donated to the causes, all of the different people out there. We appreciate the support.
Oh, and of course, you all listening to this feed.
Yes.
And we're going into, as we said, one of potentially the last jams, and it is a lead jam going to Chile. I believe that's Manco Lipe who's picked up lead, and indeed it's now.
A Roller Derby Athletics Power Jam on the floor, and this would be a great way to end it for the team from Chile. Or Chile.
Chile. Lovely work there. Mancalipe taken off of the outside, but it was an illegal hit, so he's back up, avoided a hit. Oh, lovely little jump around. That was beautiful work.
Absolutely. Definitely carving out my vote for MVP from his team.
And his team cheering him on so loudly.
Wonderful. Oh.
Some force there by Papa, but Papa picks up the forearms. And Manjelipe once more breaking out another set of 5 points. This is a beautiful last-minute dash by Chile.
It is. Look at that, 15 points in this jam so far. And looking for looking for the apex jump. Oh, my goodness. We'll pick up the cut track on that one, but time has expired on the period clock, 44 remaining in the jam, so maybe a chance here for Sweden to tack on some additional points, but a really contentious battle despite the difference in the scoreboard.
Indeed. Now Yada Yada coming round. This is going to be his first scoring pass in this jam if he can get any points on. Oh, he just folded himself around the Chilean blockers. Second time not so lucky, takes himself back on a little stumble down.
Oh, really putting it together with the defense.
They
starting
are.
To really seal off and pushing all the way past the line.
And remember, this is just day one. I think they're going to be a formidable force come tomorrow. Man Felipe back on the track. Oh, he takes a big hit just as that clock runs out on the jam. Three more points picked up for Chile, four for Sweden.
And look at that, the team from Chile is hugging each other. They're happy, they're with their performance. I think they really feel, you know, that they have improved over the course of the day. The sense of camaraderie is huge. Of course, the team from Sweden, all hugs and high fives. And now coming together on the track, you know, to greet each other. See, look, hugs on the floor, as I'd mentioned, on cue. Look at them all coming together. The big group hug on the floor. If you are a roller derby fan, you've got to love that. They just battled their hearts out the last game of the day here at Men's Roller Derby World Cup. And both teams celebrating.
It's beautiful to see.
Like everyone wins.
It is. Our final scores, unofficial at the moment, but it is 88 to Sweden, 38 to Chile. And a 50-point difference for a team that have only just started today is
That's
not
right.
to be frowned upon.
Really, and the development throughout the day, as mentioned, was huge. And so we'll see how that goes throughout the weekend. It has been my distinct pleasure to call with you.
Thank you, Ron.
Fantastic job. And hopefully on our call tomorrow, I'll do even better to keep up with you and your energy.
Thank you.
So for Holly and Rakus Ron, we will sign off and we'll see you tomorrow.
Indeed.
Okay, welcome back for the final time today to the SISU studio here at the Men's Roller Derby World Cup 2016 with me, Pandemonium.
I'm Bob Noxious.
Well, what a day it's been. We've seen 24 30-minute bouts.
Yes, we have.
Such a busy day.
Yep.
Some incredible scores on the board, some fantastic gameplay. What we're going to be doing today is the end of today now is we're going to be looking at the some bracket information. We're going to be looking at the group information for you. So we've got some graphics that we're going to pop up onto the screen so you can have a see, and we're going to talk through each of those. So if you have joined us from track one, we've already been through this with track one, but if you want to stay and listen to it again, please do.
But there's a twist, because we now have one more final score.
Absolutely.
And it has made a difference.
Yeah, so what we have gone through earlier has been tweaked slightly because we were missing some information because there was still a game in progress on track two. So that was Sweden and Chile, which has now finished the score 88-38 with a 50-point differential. Over on track one, we finished up with Team USA taking the win over Team Japan, and Team Japan unfortunately not getting any points on the board, much to the dismay of the fans.
Absolutely. First and foremost, the thing that we've been talking about all day is today and most of tomorrow is made up of pool play. Each of the 20 teams is broken down into one of four pools, five teams each. And what will happen is the team with the best record and or point differential is going to come out. The best two teams will move on to the knockout phase, much like the World Cup and every other type of World Cup. They'll move on to the knockout phase, and they are still alive for the Men's Roller Derby World Cup. The three teams that do not advance to the knockout phase have plenty of playing ahead of them yet. So don't be discouraged. They will be playing. Everybody will be playing full-length games by tomorrow evening, and it's just that they will be playing for rank, and they will be ranked from number 1 through 20.
Okay, so starting from tomorrow morning at 9, we'll have Belgium and France on track 1. 9:15, we'll have Spain and Wales on track 2. They're going to be 30-minute games, as we've seen today, moving through to 5 o'clock when we'll have a junior showcase. And then at 7 o'clock, track 1 is going to be the game for 4th place between red and blue teams. And 4th place at 7:15, this is mountain time, the time here in Calgary, over on track 2 is going to be for 4th place on teams orange and green. So there'll be full-length regulation MRDA games, and that'll be the first time we'll be seeing those full games at this point.
The full 60 minutes, yep. Full fallouts, full timeouts, yep.
Absolutely. So let's see if we can get the group graphic back up onto the screen, and we'll talk you through a little bit of information about that.
Well, what we can tell you is this. As we take a look at the red group, which is Finland, Ireland, Japan, Scotland, and the U.S., The U.S., even though they still have two games remaining, they are 2-0, and their point differential, the plus on that is already probably somewhere near around 600. Mathematically, we're going to say that that's going to be a lock that they will advance. In the catbird seat is going to be Finland, who is 2-0. However, we've got Ireland, Japan, and Scotland all in the mix. Nobody has been mathematically eliminated, and it wouldn't be impossible to see somebody even potentially jump ahead of Finland if they don't win one more game.
Absolutely. Ireland in third place in that group at the minute currently, and the reason for that being the point differential. It is higher for them because of the win that they took against Team Japan, which was a 70-point differential, so that puts them in a third slot ahead of Team Scotland, who originally we were thinking that they were going to be in third because of the wins that they've taken, but the point differential has been the effective issue there that has arranged that the way that it has. Let's go into the orange group.
Sure. Right there we have Team England that's at 2-0. We have Argentina that is at 2-1. At the moment, they are obviously they sit in the best situation. We have Italy and Sweden both at 1-1. However, Chile unfortunately has been mathematically eliminated. They have gone 0-3. So we've still got 4 out of 5 teams alive in that particular category. As we move on to the green group, which is Canada, Spain, Germany, Mexico, and Wales. Canada is one of the few that is locked. Mm-hmm. Locked, loaded, and at 3-0, they are automatically going to have a berth into the knockout phase of the World Cup. As you take a look down through the rest of it, even Mexico at 1-2, who lost two very close games to both England and Wales, even though nobody knew anything about them, have one more game to play, and should they win that game with a little help from other teams' losses, they might still be alive for this. If we take a look at the blue group, Australia is 3-0. They are an automatic lock. France is sitting in a very, very good position at 2-0. And having about 600 points in their favor as well, somewhere in there. Belgium is still mathematically in the game. The Netherlands and Puerto Rico, however, have been mathematically eliminated.
Okay, thanks, Bob, for the update there. Moving into tomorrow, anything that you think we'll see any surprises?
Well, obviously we've got at least two groups. Mm-hmm. Where a number of teams have two more games to play yet,
yeah.
And it's gonna totally shape who ends up in the knockout phase. There are teams that are gonna go home tonight feeling good about what happened, and they should, mm-hmm. but still have to think very hard about tomorrow and about how big their wins or how small their losses are going to be.
Yeah, absolutely. So some of the teams here have played three games today. Some of them have played two. It's been a mix through all of the groups. And then we'll just make up the difference in that tomorrow throughout the day. Starting a little bit later tomorrow, starting everything on track one, kicking off at 9:00 is when the first whistle is, so please tune in a little bit earlier. We'll be here from like 10 minutes or so beforehand, bringing you a recap.
We're not going home.
Yeah. Do you know what? I think we'll just stay. We'll run through. Hey, what have we got? 24 hours?
Yeah, that's it.
24 hours? Oh, clearly the jet lag is
kicking
in. 24
hours, we'll be doing this again.
12 hours. Striking. All right, awesome. So as we go into tomorrow, more exciting gameplay. We might see a little dip in the speed of the gameplay or the sort of ferocity that the teams are coming. Because I think on game one, people want to make an impression. They want to come in and show you the strength of the teams. Tomorrow will be more of the same, maybe just kind of holding back a little bit.
Tomorrow's going to be very strategic. Mm-hmm. We have to remember that every game is rostered differently. Yep. Most of these teams are coming with full rosters, some with full rosters plus a number of reserves. So I would imagine that there's a number of coaches out there tonight that are going to spend a lot of hours mulling over who they're going to play in the matchup, the matchups that they have ahead of them, because those wins are going to be very critical.
Yeah, absolutely. They probably already have something drafted up ahead of the day-to-day, but then analyzing that as we go through. But I think that leaves us in a position where we can allow you all to go to bed or wherever you are, whatever you're doing. I know if you're in the UK, it's like past 4 a.m. and there's plenty of people still up and watching. So thank you so much for joining us. It's been an absolute pleasure bringing you this footage. And we couldn't do it without our production team and Bob. So thanks so much for getting all this sorted for us.
And remember, 9 a.m. Mountain Time is the key to every day of this weekend. That's when we'll start on Saturday. That's when we'll start on Sunday.
Okay, awesome. Well, we will see you in the morning.
Good night.